In this video, we are going to solve a problem involving a common internal tangent. Let us read the problem. In the figure, segment AC is a common internal tangent of circle P and circle Q. The radius of circle P is 12 centimeters, and the radius of circle Q is 9 centimeters. If QB is 15 centimeters, find PB. These are the given data, segment AC, which is a common internal tangent of circle P and circle Q. A common internal tangent of two circles crosses or intersects the line segment connecting their centers. So this common internal tangent of circle P and circle Q crosses or intersects segment PQ connecting the center P of circle P and the center Q of circle Q. When we say circle P, we mean the circle with the center P, and when we say circle Q, we mean the circle with center Q. The other given data are the radius of circle P, which is equal to 12 centimeters. And then the radius of circle Q, which is 9 centimeters. And then the length of QB, which is 15 centimeters. We are asked to solve for PB. Segment AC is a common internal tangent of the two circles. Therefore, it is perpendicular to radius AP of circle P at point A, and angle PAB is a right angle. It is also perpendicular to radius CQ of circle Q at point C, and therefore angle QCB is also a right angle. Angle PAB is a right angle, and angle QCB is a right angle. Therefore, they are congruent. Two right angles are always congruent. There are other angles we can see here that are congruent. Angle PBA and angle QBC are congruent because they are vertical angles, and vertical angles are congruent. Therefore, we can say that triangle ABP is similar to triangle CBQ by AA similarity postulate. AA means angle. We can therefore say that PB over QB is equal to PA over QC. Substitute 15 for QB and 12 for PA and 9 for QC. So we have PB over 15 is equal to 12 over 9. Cross multiply. 9 PB is equal to 12 times 15. So this is now equal to 9 PB is equal to 180. Divide both sides by 9. So PB is equal to 20 centimeters.